will drink the same amount of bubble tea a typical bubble tea lover in Singapore drinks.
Helping me track the effects on my body is Dr. Vincent Chia. I got my blood drawn, blood pressure measured, and weight and height taken. I'm choosing drinks as they are, with no reduced sugar.
There you have it, this is my very first cup of bubble tea. I got a matcha tea with a whole bunch of stuff in it.
Somehow, that first sip always shoots this message to my brain, which just screams out, "This is so sweet!" But after a few more sips, of course you don't realize that anymore.
It's mid-afternoon, and normally I go out, I grab a cup of black coffee, been substituting it with bubble tea.
Bit like warm below and cold on top, kind of chewy with things in it.
Ooh, that sugar high always hits me in the first sip.
All right, I think I'm just wrapping up my third cup of bubble tea for the week. And you know what? It's been a bit of a struggle. The last half of this drink has just been painful.
I'm feeling just a little bit more, lethargic on a day-to-day basis. I'm not sure if it's a tea or if it's just me.
This is probably drink number 10. So I thought I'd try something different. This is a new drink with even some kind of biscuit on top of it. So, as they say, same, same, but different.
I often feel a little bit bloated after I have a cup of bubble tea, and I truly believe it's because of the pearls.
I got myself another cup of bubble tea, but as you can see, a lot of the pearls are left behind. I've actually realized that I don't really like the pearls.
So I've noticed that quite often I've been feeling more tired, a bit run down, and you know, just irritable in general. And I'm wondering if it might be because of the sugar or the caffeine. So I finally picked up my final cup of bubble tea. You know what? I'm just so tired of drinking this drink.
First of all, you gain weight. Now, weight gain of 1.9 kg is quite significant. We don't lose weight easily. So gaining 1-2 kgs isn't a good thing. Now, inflammatory markers are good predictive indicators of what are the chances you would have a heart attack or stroke in the next 10 years. Right now, it has increased to moderate risk. Lastly, your cholesterol. Total cholesterol has increased a little bit. Cholesterol generally increases your risk for heart attack and stroke. You are no longer at a low risk, but a moderate risk for cardiovascular diseases.
Wow.